Jurgen Klopp and Liverpool have shown Daniel Levy what to do if Harry Kane seals Tottenham exit. Liverpool transformed their team when Philippe Coutinho departed for Barcelona, and it's something Tottenham may well have to do if Harry Kane moves on. Harry Kane's future is the main talking point at Tottenham as we head into the final few days of the 2020-21 season. Outstanding for Spurs this campaign with 32 goals and 16 assists from 47 games in all competitions. The 27-year-old may only have two more matches to play for the club if he is to exit this summer. Constantly linked with a move elsewhere in the past due to his fine record in front of goal for club and country. Reports on Monday evening claimed that he had signaled his intention to the club that he wants to depart for a new challenge elsewhere this summer. Football London understands that Kane has not directly informed the club of his desire to leave at this stage. But his growing frustration with the consistent lack of silverware at Spurs and another disappointing campaign means he would be willing to consider a new challenge this summer. However, a potential exit will only come to fruition if Daniel Levy and the club receive a bid that they deem acceptable. With an offer in excess of 250 million probably what is needed to even start negotiations with the Lilyhites. Spurs will not allow their main man to go on the cheap, and it would have to be an eye-watering fee if he was to cut his ties with Tottenham. Liverpool were also in a similar position 4 years ago with Barcelona intent on signing Philippe Coutinho. Rejecting a 90 million bid from the Spanish giants in August and later listing a statement claiming the Brazilian wasn't for sale. Liverpool then received a transfer request from the talented player. Coutinho did remain at the club beyond the summer transfer window, but his wish was finally granted at the turn of the year after a 142 medal was agreed. Playing a key role for the Reds in the Premier League at the start of 2017-18 before his eventual exit. Manager Jurgen Klopp stressed they would only sign a replacement if it was right, and they simply wouldn't bring someone in just because he left. Already boasting a fine attack with Sadio Mane, Mohamed Salah and Roberto Firmino at Anfield, it was clear. Most notably in Tottenham's 4-1 win over the Reds at Wembley in October 2017, that other positions needed to be prioritized. the arrival of Virgil van Dijk from Southampton for 75 million in the winter transfer window took up a chunk of the Coutinho money, with the Reds chipping the rest until the summer. Now having a player at the back who transformed their backline instantly. Klopp fixed another long-term problem position with just over 55 mai spent un Roma shotstopper Alisson in July 2018. Fabinho was also another big money arrival that summer who excelled along with the aforementioned duo. While Liverpool spent again to sign Naby Keita and Xherdan Shaqiri. Finishing 25 points behind Man City in 2017-18, the club's summer business, as well as the addition of Van Dijk. Worked wonders for the Reds and they missed out on the title by just a single point the following campaign despite recording a staggering 97 points. However, they did manage to win the Champions League for the sixth time after getting the better of Tottenham in the final in Madrid with a 2-0 victory. Praised for their transfer business in wake of Coutinho's exit. Former Liverpool player Graham Souness hailed it as the best business the club has ever done when discussing the two windows that completely revolutionized Klopp's team. When you say what's the most important signing, I think you can look back to when Liverpool went from a good team to a great team, he said, as reported by Goal. They sold Coutinho and got 160 million or whatever it was. They got Alisson and they got Van Dijk and still had change left over. That's got to be the best business this club has ever done. Now it could be the turn of Leyton Spurs who need to spend their money very wisely in their quest to get back on track if Kane does depart. Getting it wrong 8 years ago when they brought in the magnificent 7-2 replace Gareth Bale as he headed for Real Madrid. Tottenham cannot afford to do the same this time or they run the risk of falling even further behind their rivals. A centre-back to transform the backline is required, while they would also need to sign a creative midfielder and a top-class striker to help cover the 48 goals contributions Kane has recorded in 47 games so far this term. Klopp and Liverpool got it bang on in 2018 and all will be hoping the same happens at Tottenham this summer if their main man is to move on for a fresh challenge elsewhere.